Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. Today I want to talk through 5 logic tips I wish I knew when I was starting. Many of these things I learned over the course of years as I was using the software. It would have been super efficient to know these things right off the bat, so I figured I'd make a video about it to hopefully help some others not waste a lot of time. Also, if you watch to the end, I'll give you a few of my hotkeys that I love using and use almost daily that really help speed up my workflow. Okay. The first tip I want to talk about is automation. Okay, you can get there by hitting the A key, and that'll spread out all your channels and give you these lanes right here. By default, the lane you're going to see is volume. This is basically where your volume fader is at. See, as I'm moving, you can see that going up and down. And this basically lets you make changes over time. I'm going to click to engage that. So you can say, hey, at measure 41, make an automation point. That's at minus 3.9. And then, you know, I want that to turn up by a few decibels as the song goes. So I'll show you what that sounds like. You can see down here, slowly turning the fader up as we go. And with automation, you're not limited to just volume. You can do just about anything. If you have smart controls set up, you can use those. You can go in here to main, control your volume, your pan, solo, mute. And then also if you have any sends happening, you can control the send amount. So this is great if you have a delay on like a bus, you can boost that send for a certain part of the song and send delay there. The next tip is the Marquee tool. So if you're not familiar with that, right up here, you have basically what your right and your left click are gonna do, or your primary and your secondary click. So by default, you're mostly going to want the main click on your pointer tool, like your regular mouse, but you can change this to be whatever you want, say scissors tool and cut regions right like that. On the secondary one, this is what happens when you hold command and click. So see, when I hold command, my cursor changes to that little plus sign. So that is whatever is set here. So I always like to leave it on marquee tool here because this guy can do a lot of different functions. So the first thing you can do with this is highlight an area, a region, and just highlight what you want and hit delete. Say you wanted to copy a region, you can also highlight and then option click and drag. And then look, I even made it MIDI for us. So that's another thing you can do with it. This is also really helpful in automation. So say, you know, in this 4-bar loop, you want to turn up the percussion just in that section. So you highlight with the marquee tool and then click and drag, and it automatically makes all 4 of those automation points. Otherwise, you got to do this kind of thing and it takes a while. So the final thing you can use the marquee for is playing just a certain section of music. So say I want to listen to these 4 measures. Instead of having to drag the playhead over here, you just highlight it and hit play. Right? And then it stops right at the end. So that's a really helpful way to quickly play back a certain section, transport around. There's lots of great uses with that. Okay, tip number 3. So this one, I went down a rabbit hole a while ago trying to make Logic look more like Pro Tools, because in general, Logic looks a lot better than Pro Tools. But the one thing Pro Tools has is really fast moving meters. They bounce up and down really quickly, and it makes it really easy to see where your meters are hitting at. And by default, Logic's meters are super slow. So I found this setting, Logic Pro, Preferences, Display, and then go over to Mixer. And so you can see right here, level meters. So by default, it's set to this IEC Type 1, which is recommended. So I'll let you see what that looks like here. So it's a nice slow movement. I personally prefer fast though. I go to faster. Very fast gets a little too jittery, but faster is awesome. You can also set your peak hold time. If you want that little line after a peak to stick around longer, you can change it. I don't really like it sticking around that long, so I left it at 800 milliseconds. But here's what it looks like with the faster meters to see if you like it. I personally think it makes it a lot easier to see what's going on, especially on your stereo out if you want to know kind of where your mix is hitting at. Tip number 4. when you go to File, Save As, you're going to have an option here to organize my project as a package or a folder. And so I believe the default is package. And so you'll get this icon that's your whole session, and that's it. But when you make a folder, you'll get your main folder here, and then it'll make an audio files folder, store all your audio there. Any freeze files you have, it'll put them there. When you bounce your session for the first time, it'll automatically create a bounces folder in here and store all your exports there. This makes it a lot easier for copying or transferring files because you can zip this whole main file that's created and it'll keep all your audio files together. I know when I was starting out, I had an issue a lot of times where I'd move the package, like this organize my project as package, I would move that around and it would lose the audio files somehow. But once I switched to using a folder, keeping it all together like this, I hardly ever lose audio files anymore. Hardly ever. Maybe never is better, but you get the point. The final thing is a real aesthetic one here. It's auto coloring. Now I know that when you bought Logic, you went into the App Store, right? Here's the App Store. And you're like, oh, I want to get Logic. Type that up. Yeah, you get that. And then you look at this first picture here, and it's so pretty, right? All these cool colors. It's so, look at that. Look at that. It's like a rainbow. And then you go in here, and you start making audio tracks, and they're all just blue. Or you're making all MIDI tracks, and they're all green. Well, if you go to Preferences, Display, Tracks, right here, this track color, by default, it's set to static, but you can actually set it to auto assign colors here. So I like the auto assign 96 colors. And then also set this region color as track color. So not only is it going to auto assign your track colors, but all your regions will correspond with that. Once you engage that, you can go add a bunch of tracks all at once. So we'll just, we'll make 20 audio tracks here and add them. And then when we open this mixer, you'll see the track colors have all automatically changed. Sometimes I do it this way and sometimes I color code it, but I definitely prefer different colors coming in as I'm adding files and adding tracks instead of it all just being blue, because that is not helpful at all. So that's it for tip 5 on the auto coloring. The last thing I want to talk about is my hotkeys that I use all the time. So the first hotkey I want to talk about is X. That will open the mixer. All of your tracks and sends and buses and all of that live here in the mixer. You can also get there by clicking here, but that's so much work. You got to move your mouse. So just hit the X button and it'll pull it all up just like that. You can also hit I and that'll toggle this single track information section over here where you have all your utility things about that track. So that's I, X for the mixer. The next one is C. Now C is going to toggle this cycle range up here. So if you've looped, you know, this 8-bar section and whenever you hit play, it's going to start you right there. If you hit C though, it'll disengage that and let you start at the beginning of the song. And then if you hit C again, boom, back to the cycle range. K is going to turn on and off your click right up here. And then Shift K will toggle the count in. So those super quick things you can toggle on and off right before you start recording, that'll really help speed up your workflow. Next is Quantize. So once you've played a section of MIDI, just highlight the whole region and hit Q and you're done. It's quantized. I believe Q defaults to 16th notes. So if you want something other than 16th notes, you'll need to go in and manually change it at that point. But especially when you're working fast and just getting ideas out, just keep hitting Q when you finish your region and it'll already be quantized and good to go. The E button will open up the editor and the editor will be like this if you're working with MIDI. So you can see your regions there. Or if you're working with audio, it will be the audio file editor. I toggle that a lot because I do a lot of work with MIDI, but also if I need to get into an audio region and see what's going on and do any flex edits or anything, you'll be able to get there quickly with E. And the last thing is huge for beginners, and that's Command K. So that will open up your musical typing, where you can actually just play right on your keyboard and get the notes you want. I know a lot of people starting out don't even have a MIDI keyboard. So once I learned how to get this up quickly and toggle it on and off, it was a game changer. So that wraps up my video about five things I wish I knew when I was starting Logic. If you enjoyed the video or have any questions, please let me know in the comments below. Also, make sure you like and subscribe. Thanks for watching.